Well, I can't say much about Frankfurt, except, shall we say, efficient. We saw about 15 seconds of the place as we raced to catch our plane. But now on board our flight from Frankfurt to Italy, I looked around at the faces of the other 18 couples that filled first class. Today, all strangers to me, but I have a feeling that before we depart for the final time, we will take home a memory that will last a lifetime. Within hours, we were standing in a world of pastel-colored buildings adorned with flower box gardens, gone with the steel and glass icons of the 20th century, replaced by cobblestone streets and stone dwellings, remaining much as it has been for centuries, where crossing the street can take on a whole new meaning, and where waiting for the bread to rise is an everyday fact. Our first stop, Villa d'Este, in the town of Serenobbio, Italy. The history of the Villa d'Este dates back more than 500 years, when Serenobbio was a little village populated by fishermen and woodcutters. First to arrive on the site where the hotel now stands were some nuns who in 1442 took refuge from a civil war in a church where today you find the gardens of the villa. The villa exchanged hands several times over the years, and in 1784 was obtained by the king, Bartholomew, an affluent aristocrat, and his very young wife. After Bart died, Donna wasted no time in remarrying to the handsome Napoleonic general, Count Demianico Pino. And since she feared that he might suffer from a nostalgia of warfare, she had a series of simulated fortresses and towers built on the slopes overlooking the garden. The general was so delighted he recruited a group of military cadets to play mock battles. You can almost see today the archers standing ready in the windows. Today the hotel is rated